I'm Donald Bosch. I'm Emeritus Professor at the University of Maryland Center for Environmental Science, and I served on the President Obama's oil spill commission after the Deepwater Horizon blowout. The drilling rig, Deepwater Horizon, was drilling a well for BP, and it was in about a mile deep water. BP and the rig operator, Transocean, were completing the well and made a series of misjudgments. Ultimately, the result was something like 4 or 5 million barrels of oil were released into the Gulf of Mexico. What happened in 2010 was really the outcome of a series of mistakes and neglect that took place long before. There were mistakes made in estimating the probability of an impact and making sure that there was adequate government oversight. There were problems with the blowout preventer that was supposed to make it very unlikely that there could ever be a blowout. We recommended that the government's programs within the Department of the Interior should be reformed to separate out the Safety Bureau from that responsible for the leasing and development of the oil and gas tracks in the Gulf of Mexico. We recommended that the industry develop a capacity to stop a blowout more quickly than they had. We recommended that there should be a more systemic way to assess safety, the safety risk, not just individual processes, but in a collective way. We recommended that Congress take action to put them in law and to make an increase, for example, the liability limits, which were ridiculously low at $75 million for an offshore blowout from an offshore facility. So some of those things were done and some were not done. My concern now, though, is with the deregulation, the rolling back of some of these safety rules that we see in the Trump administration that has occurred. One is that there is a very important thing of maintaining the proper safety margin in the drill, in the pressure that you see down in the deep in a well. And they relaxed that requirement. Secondly, I mentioned the blowout preventers. Turns out the blowout preventer in Deepwater Horizon hadn't been inspected. It wasn't working right. So this administration rolled back the requirements that there be third-party, independent inspection of blowout preventers. Finally, a third example is the requirement to have continuous 24/7 onshore monitoring by technical people onshore who are watching what's going on in the well, communicating with the people on the well. They reduce that requirement as well. I think there are a number of questions on the horizon. First of all, we need to be asking the question, where do we go in the long run? And with climate change, essentially decarbonize our economy by sort of the middle of the century, I think one should ask the question, do we need any expanded offshore drilling? When it's going to take 20 years or so to produce it,